It's your boy Salty here. We're gonna jump into some tales from the front desk. Here we go. A bird pooped on her car. This month, I celebrate my 15th anniversary in hotels. During that time, I have seen it all, or so I thought. I'm working the front desk, covering for a sick employee. It's sometimes nice to get back to my roots. I'm the AGM of my property, and back into the trenches. It's a relaxing Saturday, the sun is shining and the birds are singing. My coffee is hot. I'm assisting a guest extend his reservation when, from the periphery of the lobby, a woman approaches me hastily.
"Are you the manager?" she barks.
"Yes, I am. What can I do for?" I reply, interrupted.
"I parked under a tree in your lot last night and a bird shit on my white BMW SUV."
She was proud to stress that her vehicle was indeed white and a luxury SUV. "I'm sorry, ma'am. Please let me finish with this guest and I—"
"No, you need to do something about this now. Is there a car wash nearby?"
"I can print your directions. There's a car wash 2 miles away."
"That won't work. I'm in a hurry. Give me some damn rags."
I quickly finish assisting the gentleman in front of me, who by now is trying his best not to laugh. I grab a few microfiber rags for the guest and hand her a bottle of water.
"What the hell am I supposed to do with this?"
Wipe the bird excrement off your car?" The woman storms out of the lobby and towards her vehicle. She then deliberately pulls up to the lobby entrance and wipes the two nickel-sized bits of bird poop from the headlight area of her SUV, her white SUV, that is already dirty. Did I mention she drives a BMW? She then proceeds to smear the bird poop into her probably divorce settlement gas guzzler, making more of a mess than before. She leaves the rag on the curb and peels out of the lot. I stand there, stone-faced. My guest lets out a guttural, Paul Bunyan-esque laugh. I remember the shit woman from the day before. I checked her in and gave her directions to an upscale Italian restaurant that she probably rated as 1 star on that popular restaurant review site. I knew she was driving nearly 300 miles home on the interstate highway, where she will undoubtedly pick up tar and bugs and other road debris. I Google her address. Her McMansion sits on a plot of land that is surrounded by trees, lots of them. Big, tall, short, small.
I'd reckon that there are birds in them there trees, and they probably eat and sh**.
I cannot wait for her review to come through. I've already written my response. "Ma'am, I apologize that after a bird was finished eating, it had to relieve itself. How dare he? If you're returning to the area, we can direct you to a covered parking garage. Or I can bring my 10x10 pop-up canopy from home and reserve 2 special spots for your white BMW SUV. I will also starve all nearby birds so they die and have no way to poop, because they're dead now. Moreover, I will have all the trees in a 5-block radius chopped down at my expense. If ownership allows, we'll build a dome over the hotel. If a bird somehow does poop on the dome, I will have Pedro, our houseman, squeegee the offensive stain. Our owner will issue written apology and city council will effectively ban birds from the city limits. Thank you, bird shit lady, for making my Saturday. I could be dying of Alzheimer's and forget what the color red is, but we'll never forget you." You gotta admit, that response is on point. It is pretty funny she made such a big deal out of it considering where she lives. I never even wash my car anymore because it's either gonna rain or birds gonna shit on it right after I do. I literally cannot make this shit up. Today has been the craziest shift I have ever worked in a hotel. That's an understatement. I work mid-shifts for my hotel. I went in the morning and my GSM notifies me that our PMS is down. I can't check people in and out, give receipts, make reservations, etc. He's already on the phone with the IT, creating a ticket, trying to get it back up and going. An hour later, it's working. So now I'm backpedaling, checking people out, helping the executive housekeeper change room statuses, etc. Out of nowhere, my PMS shuts down again. I'm locked out and can't do crap. As this happens, my maintenance guy comes to the desk with a bloody hand and says, "I just cut my hand on the roof. I'm going to the hospital to get it stitched up and I'll be back." My GSM, general manager, and sales manager have all left to go to our sister property next door for a meeting. I text my GSM, let him know that everything is shut down again and that I'm calling IT to get it up and going again. So I call IT off the hotel phone so we can get it rolling again. As I'm on the phone with IT, a guy walks in and says, "I have the meeting space booked. Can you let me in?" So I switch to the handheld phone and walk over to the meeting space and try to open the door with my master key. It doesn't blink. It doesn't flash colors and won't open. F***. Our maintenance guy is at the hospital. All of the managers are gone. IT is talking my ear off and next thing I know, the executive housekeeper calls me on the walkie-talkie and says none of our doors are opening. So now I have a guest trying to get into the meeting space, a non-working PMS, and no master keys opening doors. My next move is to call our sister property's maintenance guy next door to come help. He does and immediately starts working on the meeting space door. My managers come back and start helping where they can. After about another hour, we finally get our PMS back up, and in another 30 minutes, our doors are working. Great, so now I'm playing catch up at 2:30 in the afternoon, trying to get everything done before 3 p.m. check-in. Here's where it gets so insane that I literally cannot make this shit up. It's afternoon time, so I replenish the coffee. This is important, I promise. Then I check in a few guests. Then this guy walks into the lobby and says, "Hi, my name is such and such, and I need to check on the status of my application." I tell him to wait a moment and go grab the general manager. She then explains to me that Bob is a homeless gentleman that comes in posing as an applicant so he can come in and take our cookies, breakfast cereal, bananas, coffee, etc. He's already been removed from the property by police multiple times and banned from returning to our property. At this point, he's blatantly trespassing. She comes out and asks him to leave while on the phone with police. He tries to argue back and forth with her until the police arrive. They of course tell him that he cannot be on the property and ask him to leave, not return, and that he needed to return the items he stole. This man flips, throws the coffee I had just made at a guest. Cookies and bananas are thrown across my lobby floor and a soda hits and busts all on the lobby wall. Police restrain him, he's gone. At this point, I'm ready to pull my hair out and ready for a cigarette. So I go outside, and halfway through my cigarette, my general manager comes on the walkie-talkie and says there is a man wearing jeans, a gray hoodie, and a gray hat on the property that just tried to attack a housekeeper on the elevator. She tells me to take one flight of stairs and the maintenance guy, who is back on property, to take the other and do a property walk. Others are outside checking the parking lot, and others are on the first floor checking common areas. By the time I make it to the third floor, my general manager gets on the walkie and says that he's been restrained by police and that we can go back to doing our regular duties. The maintenance guy and I happen to be on the same floor, so we both get on the elevator to go back down to the first floor. It's going down and stops to let someone on. This man is wearing jeans, a gray hoodie, and a gray hat. The maintenance guy and I are looking at each other in disbelief, and I'm thinking, this has to be a coincidence. So I open a text to the maintenance guy to ask him if they're sure they got the right guy. And the freaking elevator gets stuck. As soon as this happens, Gray Hoodie Man starts chanting, "The United States military, suicide, suicide, suicide." And then giving a military ID after he says that statement. Y'all, I literally can't make this shit up. So of course, the maintenance guy grabs me and pins me in the corner in case the guy started to attack. Maintenance guy is a tall and well-built guy, so I knew that if Gray Hoodie were to attack, he was going to have to go through him first. I get on the walkie-talkie and say that the elevator is shut down, the police have the wrong guy, and that the maintenance guy and I are stuck on the elevator with him. All hell breaks loose. General manager flipped his shit and is standing outside the door trying to pry it open. We were on the elevator with this guy for 45 minutes while the fire department tried to get us out. Gray Hoodie Man sat there and chanted the same statement over and over again. He never moved, he never looked at us. The man didn't even know we were there. Y'all, I have never been genuinely afraid of a guest, but today was that day. Finally, they get us off and I bolt to the back office and have the freaking panic attack I'd been holding in for the last 45 minutes to an hour. At this point, I have an hour left on my shift. I'm broke and need the freaking hours, so I collect myself and go back to the desk. Gray Hoodie is escorted off the property. We all assumed he was going to be taken to the hospital to be checked out because there was genuinely something wrong. Nope. I didn't know this. Neither did the other staff members. We kept working and all trying to wrap things up so we can all go the hell home. I go out and smoke, then I come back in to use the bathroom. Y'all, I open the freaking door and Gray Hoodie is sitting on the bathroom sink, chanting the same statement. He came in the back door this time. We have two sets of double doors on our property, so the desk did not see him. Neither did anyone else. Needless to say, I flipped sh**. I walk back to the lobby to find it full of high school students here for a school function. Great, let's call the cops and freak out a bunch of teenagers. I grab the maintenance guy and tell him that the guy is back in my bathroom. Go guard it and don't let him leave. I go in the back and call 911, get off the phone with 911, and call the general manager. They come and take the guy to the hospital. Come to find out, this is a military veteran under a severe PTSD episode. My heart broke for this man. Thankfully, the police were able to take him to get the help he needed. Overall, I am done with today. I will be taking a very hot bath, drinking a full bottle of wine, and then getting back up in the morning to go back to a literal dumpster fire in the morning. Edit, thank you everyone for your kind comments and support. It is truly appreciated. I like to say to those commenting about me possibly seeking professional help should I start seeing signs of PTSD. I agree with you and will do so if it arises. As of this time, I am okay, breathing, and thankful we are able to get him the help he needed. After I realized what was going on, that was my main goal. Holy cow, that one's insane. I think I would quit after that. That right there would have just been my last day. Hopefully the guy got the help he needed. As for Bob the homeless man, I sure hope he's doing better as well. If you have to fake that you're working at a hotel just so you can eat the cookies and bananas, you probably got a problem. Alright everybody, let me get your feedback in the comments below and we'll see you all in the next video. Peace out.